What's up, guys? I'm Bobby Dean. Thank you for tuning into my newest video about my trip to New York City during the COVID-19 virus. Some of you may know it as the coronavirus. And I know what you're thinking, Bobby, why the fuck would you travel during this time? But you know what? That's a little personal and we're not gonna get into it. But all you need to know is that I made it to New York City and back to Los Angeles, California, nice and healthy and safe. And we're just gonna talk about my experience. So if you're sticking around, thank you. And I hope that you like this video, subscribe and share it with a friend. Thanks. When I first got to LAX, it was very eerie, very different. There weren't a lot of people, which is crazy. If you've ever been to LA or stopped by LAX, you'll know what I'm talking about. Like, there is never any space to go anywhere. Like, I'm talking about cars, even to stop for 2 seconds to unload your bags from the car. Like, LAX is always crazy. So this was the first time ever where I actually got to LAX. I would say, like, not even 20 minutes, probably less than that. There wasn't much of a struggle to get out of the car or to find a spot. Everything was pretty easy, even to check myself in and to get to the actual gate for the airline that I was traveling with. Same, everything was pretty smooth.
All right, so I'm at the airport now. Obviously, we are in the middle of the whole coronavirus shit and everybody's like really paranoid to take flights and everything, but I'm heading to New York to go be with my family, so that's a must. It's inevitable, but the airport is definitely empty as fuck. I know everybody thinks that everybody's in like masks and gloves and things like that, but you're not. A lot of regular schmegular people everywhere. Like, yeah, no, it was empty as fuck on the way over here to the airport, and it is empty as fuck in here too, so we'll see how the actual flight looks once we're on the plane.
The flight itself was pretty smooth. There weren't a lot of people on the plane. I would say that there was mostly like 15 people, and just about everybody had a row to themselves, so that was also pretty crazy. I don't think you see that too often. Then once I got to New York City, same, their airport was pretty empty, probably even worse than LAX, but I think that's because New York is a big hotspot for the virus, so there weren't a lot of people there, whether it was the workers or travelers. It was very empty. It just felt very weird to be walking through the airport like that. Almost felt like we were in a scary movie. I know that the other passengers, when they got off the plane too, like everyone was just looking around, like it was just unbelievable. Once I did get to the outside of the airport, I got into my Uber. That was even a little bit challenging lately. I mean, I don't know if other people use Uber like that when they travel, but I do. It was not that easy to get an Uber as it normally would be. Then on top of that, my Uber was a lot more expensive than normal, which I guess that's also understandable too. People are putting their health at risk to take us passengers to and from our destination, so I get it. But my rate for the Uber was pretty crazy. I've never paid that much to take an Uber in New York before. Never. But yeah, once I got to New York, I will say this, a lot of the people there are, for the most part, listening to the whole social distancing stuff. People in the street were behaving themselves. People were keeping a distance. Majority of the people in New York did have gloves and masks. Like, they're definitely moving forward with that. Unlike LA, where I don't see that many people wearing their gloves and masks or taking the extra precaution, so that's a little sad. But New York does have us beat on that part. Then when I was going grocery shopping with my cousin, they have a lot of product. LA, you guys need to take notes. Don't be greedy bastards. Like, share the toilet paper and the groceries with the rest of us, okay? But New York was fully stocked, and we went grocery shopping a couple times while I was out there, so I know that it wasn't just one location that was fully stocked, multiple locations. Now, they started doing the whole waiting in line thing outside of the store to go inside, also to help with the social distancing. I appreciate that in New York, a lot of the stores had different little signs at the checkouts or throughout the businesses that were motivating the employees and just encouraging them and, you know, just giving them some positive words to thank them for their service during this hard time, which, to be honest, I've never seen that in LA. I'm yet to see somebody thank them like that. I only see that on social media. But in New York, they had them at a lot of establishments, which is really nice because we do appreciate the workers that are putting themselves out there during this crazy time. Like, a lot of us have basically been left without work during this situation, and those who are being out there, we appreciate you. It's really scary out there, so thank you for that. Yeah, and then other than that, in New York, the only thing I will say is, I mean, same like LA, we couldn't get any food, we couldn't sit anywhere, we weren't allowed to eat at restaurants, so all we could do was get our food to go. And then from there, what we did do, because with my family in New York, we do have my grandma, who is a lot older, she's 98, so we are definitely trying to do the whole social distancing, even with her, not have that many people around her, especially people who are in and out, you know. So we're taking the extra precautions, but because of that as well, we couldn't really be at home eating and doing things like that. So we did have to resort to eating at the park. Luckily at that time, they didn't have the curfews, but eventually we did see the whole curfew thing being placed, you know, I guess into effect. So that got a little scary to see the streets of New York so empty by a certain time, where New York is usually really loud, especially where my family's from. Like, we're used to seeing the streets pretty, pretty busy. But and that's why I need all the energy that you bring. No fight. I would say probably like my third or fourth day of being in New York, you would see police officers literally like roaming the streets and checking, and people rushing to get home. Like, it's just wild. Now, heading back to LA was probably even crazier. So for my flight back home, the airport probably looked even more empty. You would see less people, less workers. And then the flight, my first flight coming to New York from LA, I said, what, 15, 20 people? This flight, like leaving New York to get to LA, less people. I would say 15 at the very most, probably 10 people. And it was really weird. We were not given anything, no snacks. I think literally all I was offered was water, same for the other people, the other passengers on the plane. And even like little things where you normally wouldn't even think about it, you know, like when I finished my beverage, I wanted to obviously like give it to the flight attendant to throw it away, and the girl was just kind of like, you know, like, normal activities, we can't even do that. I can't hand someone something anymore. Like, this virus is pretty outrageous that we have to change our way of living. Basic things that we would normally do, can't do those anymore. I did have a safe flight back home. People weren't talking, people weren't even watching stuff on their phone or iPads or nothing. Like, literally everyone was sleeping. It's like the vibe was just dead, like very, very dark, just not a cool energy. But when I did make it back to LAX, maybe because of the time of my arrival, I did see a few more workers, but same as in New York, trying to catch my Uber to get back home was a little bit of a pain in the butt. Luckily out here in LA, it wasn't as expensive, I guess, because people are still a little more active out here in Los Angeles. So that was pretty normal as far as my Uber rate. But coming back, I can say that I took the extra care and precaution to stay quarantined, and luckily I can say that as of yet I'm still healthy, thank God, and I made it back. I traveled to New York and back during this virus, and I made it home safely. So if you're watching this, yes, it's crazy, but it's not that crazy, but it's crazy. So yeah. Lots of people are getting sick out there. Lots of people are losing loved ones, friends, everything. Just be safe out there, guys. And thank you for watching this video. Have a good one, y'all.